there is a friend of mine working on film now, talking about this subject. It's very sensitive one. And people talk about it without any knowledge and historical background. The problem between Syria and Lebanon, it's a very long one and needs a lot of time to talk about it, because you won't actually make any good if you just say, I hate Lebanese or I hate Syrians. Or the Lebanese were wrong, or the Syrians were wrong. It's not like that. It's a bigger matter. But quite briefly, in order to establish Israel in this area, the West had to divide the whole area into countries and contours. Okay. The Sykes people, the two prime ministers, foreign minister, the British and the French prime minister, they opened a bottle of wine. But they finished drawing the maps of this area before finishing the bottle of wine. Without anybody asking us whether we like this drawing or not, nobody asked us. The Sykes-Picot agreement between France and according to this agreement, established the new countries such as Syria, Lebanon, Jordan, and Palestine, which came later to be Israel. From this, you actually can understand why there are so many political problems in our area. And we as Syrians, or Lebanese, or Jordanian, or Palestinian, when we understand this, I think we will not have reasons to hate each other.
Yeah.
The Syrian actually entered Lebanon to help stopping the civil war. And that was by the demand of the Lebanese government and the president at that time, the Slimane Franchi, the late Slimane Franchi. He asked Syrian troops to enter Lebanon to stop the civil war. And the civil war was between Christians and Muslims. Syria went into Lebanon to defend the Muslims, the Christians who were really losing the battle. We should not imagine our area without Christians, because this area was Christian before it came to be Muslims. And we are proud to live together, Muslims and Christians. It's our heritage. I am Muslim, but Christianity is my heritage. And I'm proud in every church in Syria. They are as important for me as mosques. And that was the role of Syria, to stop this war. And later on, there were lots of complications, because this is a country, Lebanon, with a lots of Tawaif, what you call it?
Ethnicities. Yeah.
Okay. Lot of them, they are fighting together. For any country, whether it was Syria or Nigeria or Brazil, involved in this, it will really be criticized very, very much. So it's very complicated. I'm not going to really talk about it now, because I don't want to create any misunderstanding. But for Lebanon, I want to tell you something in my belief. Somebody's troop has to enter Lebanon at that time, either Syrian or Israelis.
Yeah, I prefer Israelis.
You prefer Israelis? Because the West won't sit down watching Christians slaughter in Lebanon. And the West will ask Israel to invade them, to protect Christians. So it's better if Syria go in and protect the Christians. Because our brothers, we are the same families.
Yeah.
In Syria, you find the same family, half of it Christians and the other half Muslims. The rest Syria. Syria, Al-Kubra, the great city, including Lebanon, Syria, and Jordan. But we as Arabs and Muslims, we ask, we cry that we should get together to put all the efforts to really make something in this world, to defend ourselves, to explain ourselves, to be part, positive part, a nice part of this world, because we deserve it. We deserve it. But sometimes we are very narrow-minded in looking to things. And we engage ourselves in very, very silly things. And we forget about the substantial things.
Do you think that all Arabs like this?
No, but it's a trend. It's
because
a trend.
You said we.
No, I mean, it's a trend. It's a trend. Not because we are like that, but we have lots of problems and misconceptions. Unless we overcome all that, we will never be able really to draw a good way to a really bright future, in my belief.